because I am very, as you say, bubbly and outgoing, that I like to talk to my classmates. Like, I'm leaving next week. So I talked to one of my classmates about taking notes on my behalf. So if I miss that class, I can get those notes. So I love taking classes with my peers because I love to interact with them. And I don't think they even know I am differently abled. And if they know, I don't care. Because, I'm like Rachel said, well, just like everybody else, I want to be treated like such. So I'm just happy to exactly interact with my peers. And normally when I take my class, I like to do an introductory email to my professor, letting him know my job, letting him know I'm going to be traveling a lot, like heavy-duty traveling. And all my professors have been easygoing, and they know. Because sometimes they go, oh, I see you on TV, or whatever the case may be. We get it. We'll accommodate you. So I've been getting the accommodations from my professor without a problem.
You know, you just gave in that little bit a lot of good advice for people out there. First of all, you yourself reach out to your peers, just like anybody else would. I need help with notes. So you do that reaching out. And then you do the reaching out to your professor and you tell your professor, hey, this is the deal.
Yeah, this is what's up.
And this is, I'm going to need these accommodations. But you handle that yourself, which is why you're such a good ambassador for everybody.
Thank you. And I do have a mentor in the class that also helps me as well.
Oh, that's wonderful. So you have a...
Have you
done that your whole journey? Because there's a lot of kids going to college now, and you're going to community college, which people need to know is an option. There are four-year schools to go to, and that's great for some people, but other people might want to work a job and go to community college. So have you had a mentor the whole time? Like in each class, do you do that, or is that just this class?
In high school, I had a teacher's aide up to a certain point, because when I had that aide in school, and didn't know that's in 10th grade. I had a mentor that went, a teacher's aide that wanted to hold my hand in the hallway straight across it. I'm like, no, thank you. I got this. But now throughout college, I do have a mentor that helps me in my class. Figures out, okay, this is the study guide. This is what you have to look at. She helps me take notes because I still need that.
Okay.
But they help me figure out what's needed for the next class.
Okay. And a mentor could be another peer. A mentor doesn't necessarily mean what the typical aid that you just gave an example of, which makes me laugh. You know, we have to remember that. There's so many aides who never got any training and mm-hmm. don't know what is really proper help and what is not. And
exactly.
That's an FYI to every school system out there. You need to train your paraprofessionals along with your teachers and your administrators because it's not being done enough. And
exactly.
You just gave a great example. Kayla McKeon, who is literally traveling all over and changing the world, did not need somebody to hold her hand in high school.
Yes. Went backwards.
Yeah.
That's, oh, wow. So
yeah,
okay. That was an interesting conversation. So
yeah, it kind of was.
Love is all.